for a week now with everything happening in Cuba, you know, no Democrats basically have said anything bad about communism. If anything, they've subtly endorsed it or not said anything, like AOC and Omar and Bernie and the rest of them. But yesterday, Biden actually did say the C word, and he kind of condemned it in his sleepy way. Take a look at this clip.
Communism is a fail system, universally fail system. And I don't see socialism as a very useful substitute, but that's another story. Cuba is a, unfortunately, a failed state in repressing their citizens.
Boy, inspirational, huh? That guy, could he wake up a lot of people? All right, let's just do this real quick, one shot for each of you. I mean, that he choked that out to me. Like, there's just nothing behind it. And they are socialists, and that's not that far from communist. David, am I overstating this?
Yeah, I mean, Joe Biden has been in political life for so many decades, and you know, I think his brain is mush at this point. So sometimes an old script will pop into his head, maybe from 1985 or something like that. And I've got a feeling that's what happened here. I'm pretty sure that they denied him a scoop of ice cream that evening. Yeah. At the White House, and you know, had him sit alone in a corner after giving that speech.
Right. When Trump has ice cream, it's national news. Biden gets ice cream, and it's like the greatest thing ever. Rogan, I mean, at this point, do you think the Democrats in effect are socialists? Like, is there any meaningful distinction between the average Democrat at this point and a socialist, which of course is only a stone's throw away from a communist?
You know, anytime I call Democrats socialists or communists, I always get people in the comments, do you even know what communism is? Do you even know what socialism is? I think they're just flagrant authoritarians, and the economic system is really just secondary to the crushing government power that they want to enact on, you know, these peasants that inhabit this beautiful country. You know, we went from Ronald Reagan, Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall right in his face to, hey, Mr. Castro, could you, you know, maybe sort of kind of be nicer? Socialism isn't so good. I mean, come on.
Ron, you're not acting as Rogan's lawyer in this capacity. Are they socialists? Oh, I think you're muted, Ron.
You see what they did? They're trying to silence me. They're not socialists. They are, first of all, it depends on who we mean by they. The Democrats who are in charge of the Democratic Party are not socialists. They're not interested in the redistribution of wealth. They have a great deal of that wealth. They're not interested in the change of management or ownership of the means of production. They don't, none of them has even read Marx. They are crony capitalists. What they are doing is playing to their left-wing base, mm-hmm. and activist and donor base, which, you know, as being a Bolshevik-style party, this is the one thing that the Democrats will always have over the Republicans, which is that they have party and message discipline. And the rule among Democrats is no enemies to the left ever. So whatever it takes.
Yeah, it's actually a great point. Like, Pelosi is not willing to give up her hundreds of millions of dollars and the ton of money she made on Wall Street this week. So she's not a socialist in that regard. She's just messaging to those guys.